Welcome to the platform with Asian Kinaito India Limited. I have with me, I'm Praful Gattani, I'm director of the company, and I have with me our chairman, Mr. Kamlesh Patel, also our CFO, Mr. Amrendo, and our analyst, Mr. Kalpesh, along with me. Welcome to you, all of you, once again. Please go ahead. If you allow me, then I can continue with the basic informations related to the results. Results have already been published, and I am sure you all have gone through it, which shows promising numbers and positive numbers this year again. And we have a very strong futuristic view and base coming this year also. Although the first quarter is hit and damaged by COVID-19 effect generally and overall by, to all the manufacturers, including us also, especially the month of April, which was not very healthy due to lockdown and due to unavailability of the transportation, raw material and labor, etc. But very fortunately, we are one among the first leaders in the industry who have started their all the factory. I'm pleased, and I'm pleased to inform you, and I am very, very happy to tell you that out of 900 manufacturers, so far only 300 manufacturers have started, restarted their plant and running on partial capacity. But we are the only one who have started all 10 manufacturing units, and we are running with the full capacity as of now. Plus, we have immense number of orders and sufficient numbers of orders which are giving us complete capacity utilization from May onwards. So that is also a good sign that we are recovering and we are doing pretty well. So considering this, I think we hope that this quarter onwards everything would be normal and we would perform better in this year again. I know there will be a small effect of the first quarter, but we would recover in second, third and fourth quarter very nicely, we are very sure. At Asian, we are also looking at very aggressively and very positively international market, especially the market where there is a huge and very heavy anti-dumping duty to China has been levied, like USA and Australia and some part of Europe also. There we would be getting a much larger share because not only we are competitive in terms of quality, we are also competitive in terms of prices with China. So an Indian brand overall in international market is preferred over China. So this year, because of this international political issues, we would be getting advantage and we would be getting a much larger international market share. Same will happen in Saudi Arabia and in Middle East also. Because we are one of the registered vendors in Saudi Arabia, we would get a much larger share this year. In turn, total balancing will be done between the international market and domestic market. Whatever we have lost during COVID in first quarter, we would recover in the last quarter, and we would recover with international increased sales also. So we hope that this year is going to be again comparatively a better year than the last year with us. Also, our chairman has decided and converted a company into a very heavy digitalization program to reduce the marketing cost, which is something around 12 to 15% in general for all the companies. Our competitors, they are ranging between 14 to 16% as a sales cost of sales, and our is normally is a 12% cost. To reduce this and to implement the Atmanirbhar program of our Honorable Chief Minister, our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, our chairman has designed one specific program to increase the manpower utilization in the rural areas to give them the benefits and give them the more employment. So I would also request our chairman to brief you about this Atmanirbhar program. So Kamlesh bhai, thoda sa Atmanirbhar program ke bare mein, if you can brief.
Hello. Hi. Just Atmanirbhar program all over India mein we are launching this first time. Generally koi bhi company ka operation cost mein sales cost marketing cost huge hai. Hamari bhi cost 12% hai, 10 se 12% hamara sales cost hai. Aur limited aaj koi bhi tehsil tak hamara person sales person jata hai, uske niche downline tak hamara person nahi ja sakta hai kyunki jitne aadmi rakhenge itni cost badhti jayegi. Generally, हम बी और सी और जो एकदम रूरल टाउन एरिया है वहाँ हम कैसे पहुँचे, और कोविड के टाइम में हमने देखा कि भाई जो गांव में इतनी इफेक्ट नहीं है जितनी मेट्रो में आज बॉम्बे दिल्ली बैंगलोर चेन्नई जो बंद है, और अभी भी वहाँ नॉर्मल पोजीशन आने में एक महीना और जाएगा। लेकिन जो आज की तारीख में एशियन का जो सेल अप्रैल में कुछ नहीं हुआ लेकिन मई महीने में जो सेल हुआ, मई से जून में अच्छा हुआ, तो जो सेल हो रहा है वो बी और सी और निचले टाउन में हो रहा है। तो हमने आत्मनिर्भर प्रोग्राम जो ऐसा किया है कि हमारा जो एक तहसील होता है वो तहसील के नीचे छोटे छोटे गांव है, वो तो गांव में भी टाइल्स तो लगती है लेकिन वो टाइल्स हमारी लगे और हम उसका मार्केट का स्टेक पूरा ले। तो हमने आत्मनिर्भर प्रोग्राम में जैसे कोई भी आदमी उसमें ज्वाइंट हो सकता है, आईबीपी हमारे एजेंट है, इंडिविजुअल बिजनेस पार्टनर। तो हमने रथ यात्रा के दिन हमने प्रोग्राम लॉन्च किया, जैसे कोई भी ऑटो मोड में कोई भी आदमी उसमें जुड़ सकता है, रिटायर प्रिंसिपल, टीचर, एलआईसी के एजेंट, पोस्टमैन, ट्रैवल एजेंट। तो हमने जो ये लॉन्च किया उसके दिन ही हमारे पास में 80 लोग, हमने ट्रायल पायलट प्रोजेक्ट किया, दो गांव में किया है, तो 80 लोग उसमें ज्वाइंट हुए। वो 80 लोगों को हमने ट्रेनिंग दिया, वो ट्रेनिंग में हमारा बेसिक कंडीशन है कि भाई उसको बाइक और कार आना चाहिए, उसके बाद में सेकेंडरी उसका पैन कार्ड नंबर होना चाहिए, आधार कार्ड, और उससे एक चेक लेते हैं हम, और वो आदमी हमारे साथ में जुड़ जाता है। जब जुड़ता है उसको ट्रेनिंग के बाद में हम बोलते हैं कि तेरे नजदीक के 10 गांव हैं, वो 10 गांव में तू एशियन का आईबीपी एजेंट हो गया। उसके बाद में वो सैनिटरी, सीपीपीटी, टाइल्स, मार्बल, क्वार्ट्ज, एडेसिव कुछ भी बेच सकता है। उसको एक लॉगिंग प्रोग्राम में एक ओटीपी नंबर जनरेट होता है, ओटीपी नंबर से कंपनी की पूरी डिजाइनिंग, पूरा कैटलॉग, पोर्टफोलियो उसके पास में चला जाता है। और जो गांव के अंदर टाइल्स की रिक्वायरमेंट है, जैसे 50,000 का टाउन है, 25,000 का टाउन है, उससे छोटा टाउन है कोई भी टाउन, तो उसको टाइल्स की रिक्वायरमेंट है, तो वो रिक्वायरमेंट में वो इनसाइड जाके जो डीलर के पास में स्टॉक है वो ऑटो मोड में जनरेट होता है। वो गूगल के मैपिंग के थ्रू 50 किलोमीटर के रेडियस में जो डीलर है उसके वहां जो स्टॉक है वही वो आत्मनिर्भर प्रोग्राम आईबीपी एजेंट के पास में वो दिखेगा। वो स्टॉक से सामने वाले को सपोज बाथरूम में क्या लगाना है, बेडरूम में क्या लगाना है, तो वो सामने वाले को डिजाइन सिलेक्शन करके दिखाता है कि आपका सपोज बेडरूम होगा तो ऐसा होगा, बाथरूम होगा तो ऐसा होगा। फिर सामने वाला पूछता है कि उसका कैलकुलेशन में कॉस्ट क्या पड़ेगा, तो ऑटो मोड में जाके वो कैलकुलेशन करके व्हाट्सएप से कॉस्टिंग निकाल के दे सकता है, उसकी रिक्वायरमेंट खत्म होता है। तो नजदीक जाके डीलर के पास में देखना है तो प्रोडक्ट भी देख सकता है, नहीं देखना है तो वो अपने को डायरेक्ट कंपनी में ऑनलाइन सिस्टम से पेमेंट करेगा, और जो आईबीपी एजेंट है उसको 3% उसको कमीशन भी चला जाएगा, और हमारा जो डीलर है उसको ऑटो मोड में ही वो सर्विस जो रिक्वायरमेंट है, छोटी क्वांटिटी की रिक्वायरमेंट है, वो गांव और तहसील तक वो डिलीवर करेगा। हमारा ये प्रोग्राम हमने पहले फर्स्ट दो जगह से लॉन्च किया है और पूरे गुजरात में हम एक 3 महीने में कंप्लीट करेंगे पूरा मॉडल, और उसको ऑल ओवर इंडिया लॉन्च करेंगे। पूरे इंडिया में हमारे 1000 पीपल हर जगह पे होंगे, छोटे से छोटी जगह पे हमारा आदमी होगा। तो आत्मनिर्भर प्रोग्राम हमारी ओवरऑल सेल्स कॉस्ट कम करेगा, और जो सेकेंडरी सेल डीलर के वहां होना चाहिए, जितने हमारे 300 एक्सक्लूसिव शोरूम है वहीं से हमारा सेकेंडरी सेल जनरेट हो, और हमारी जो मार्केटिंग कॉस्ट 12% है वो उसको रिड्यूस करे। और हमने एग्जिस्टिंग ये फर्स्ट टाइम हमने हमारी जो सेल्स कॉस्ट है उसमें भी वेरिएबल सिस्टम डाला है चाइनीज स्टाइल से, कि भी जितना आप दौड़ेंगे इतना आप ज्यादा कमाएंगे, और सबको बिजनेस पार्टनर बनाए। 600 लोग हमारी मार्केटिंग टीम में एट प्रेजेंट है जो कंपनी के पेरोल में है, और उनको हमने एक एशियन बिजनेस पार्टनर बनाया है। तो ये फर्स्ट टाइम हमने जून महीने में जो सैलरी किया है वो सैलरी भी हमने वेरिएबल पे से, वेरिएबल सिस्टम से किया है। तो उससे हमको लगता है कि हमारा आने वाले समय में जो फिक्स कॉस्ट है वो कम होगा, और लोग और आईबीपी एजेंट से हमारा सेकेंडरी और वो सेल कम ज्यादा होगा, तो हमारी कॉस्ट वहीं कम हो सकती है, और जो सैंपलिंग कॉस्ट जो ऑलवेज हमारा 1.5 से 2% होता है, तो ये साल हमारी सैंपलिंग कॉस्ट भी 1% कम होगी और मार्केटिंग कॉस्ट हमारी ओवरऑल 2% कम हो, और जो 600 लोग ट्रैवलिंग करते हैं तो टीएडीए की जो कॉस्ट है वो भी हमारा 25 से 30% है, वो भी रिडक्शन होगा। तो एक बड़ा एक नया मोड से हमने मार्केटिंग स्टाइल एडॉप्ट किया है और काफी उम्मीद है कि ये साल नेक्स्ट जो हमारा फर्स्ट क्वार्टर में जो डीग्रोथ हुआ है वो हम सेकंड थर्ड और फोर्थ क्वार्टर में हम कंप्लीट करें और ओवरऑल हम पूरे साल में ग्रोथ में आए। तो
we have already lined up product range and our total like mix of products, basically a product basket to offer to international market, and we are adding now even one product which is called quartz into our one kind of a vertical which will be focused on US market and which has got a very good potentials in west especially. So this would also add on into our top line as well as strengthen our bottom line also. So that would be another focus this year we would be doing it. We are also making some sizable capex also to increase the quantity and quality in quartz. With this, in fact, we have another advantage of getting not only market for quartz, but with this networking, we will get market for tiles also, and it will strengthen our international business in tile segment also. There are a lot of good advantage that international duties have been reduced and made favorable to India, specifically in case of Australia, in case of US, Canada, and some part of countries like France and Germany. So these countries will have an open door for us. We are already targeting and focusing on these markets to replace the Chinese tile market, because cost-wise and quality-wise, both are we are very competitive, and we can offer definitely a much better product basket now with the large range of product available with us, as well as a range of outsourcing products also. So these two together will help us a lot. Even this year, what we have done is that, you know, we have focused more on outsourcing to make company asset light, basically. Our turnover, almost more than 60% would be coming from the outsourcing products also, which will reduce our fixed cost and strengthen our top line also. I think, and I would now transfer to Mr. Amrendu, our CFO, for add on something financially to you.
In continuation of our chairman and Director Mr. Ghatani has said, I'd like to add some more points. Like what we are doing in our plant, we are doing a good product mix in our plant where we are outsourcing the low cost, low margin product to outside vendors, and we are going for high margin product in our plant. That will continue, that we are spending on research in our plant itself, and extra lines we are adding for quartz and other facilities. To cater the need of US market, which is now having an exponential growth. This we are appointing our exclusives in US market. Our dealerships and our showrooms are coming up there. So we'll have a big range of product displays there, and we are asking for a very good market share there. Like opportunity from China has opened up a door of around 16,000 crore market to Indian players and world over. However, being a dominant player and a cheap and a better version, we are expecting that we will be in 2020-21, this will be coming as a boost for us, and we are going to encash this opportunity. So that is why we are bullish on our product, and whatever the losses we have incurred for the month of April, that we will be able to cover it up in the entire year of 2021. And we feel that we will be able to have a positive growth of around 4-5% year on year in 2020-21. Coming back to our results, we had a degrowth in quarter four. That is because the lockdown started staggered way. It started in Kerala, then it came to Bangalore, Chennai, then Delhi, Mumbai, Pune, and then it went to Punjab also. So this staggered lockdown started in the month of March itself, and that has we lost around 140 odd crores of sales, estimated sales, it could have been larger also. Estimated sales in the last month, which brought us down by around 28% in our sales. However, in bottom line, as we said, that we were expecting this to happen in India, since we had a very good connections in China and we found out that this epidemic is coming in a bigger way in India. So we planned it out, the futuristic thought of our management. We discussed it internally that this is going to happen in the month of March itself. So we pushed our value sales in the month of February itself, and then we understood that March will not be that good. So we lost on sales, but the effort we did in the last quarter, on saving our marketing cost, in saving our sampling, branding, tours and travel cost, all those product launch, we shifted our product launch, all those things, and digitalization of our marketing strategy, that has helped us to bring our profit in last quarter also. Wherever, even though we lost 28% of sales, you will find that our profits have increased. So this was a combined strategy of our people who were working with us, our management who are having the pulse of the market, and the futuristic strategy that we had. Coming on to major savings we made in gas prices, we were the pioneer in using gas technology in our product. A half of Morbi is still in coal and other technologies, but we were pioneer about that. And we for future years also, we have installed a very cost-efficient gas kiln in our product line, in our assembly line. So that will also help in bringing the cost down. We are also using natural gas propane mix in our product. So that is one strategy to bring our cost down. We are in such an area where we get a little bit of subsidy in one of our companies, group companies. So that also helps for a longer one. And this, coming back to the marketing cost, the brandings, the tours and travels, the sampling cost, the display cost will be reduced, and we will put our effort in digital marketing, which will have a positive say. And with the variable strategy we brought in sales and marketing salaries, that will also enhance our penetration in the market, because people will be more motivated to go inside the market, deep penetration and all. Thank you.
With COVID, there is a serious effect has been observed. It is like, you know, migration of labor from metros to B and C and D grade cities, and which is our forte and which is our market basically. So there would be a degrowth in metros. However, there will be a substantial growth in B and C and D class of cities because of ample of labor is available, and cheap labor would be available. Also, people would go for budget houses, economy houses, and government may roll on further more goodies for this particular segment. So this is our niche market, in fact, I would say. And Asian is basically a company which is not into a very high value and premium products. We are into a mid and upper mid class kind of a tile segment, which is a market which is basically you can see in B and C and D class of cities. So this market would support us further this year, and it will give us a good supporting numbers also at the end of this year, I think. And anything is to be added by our yes.
We can open a floor for a question and answer session.
Can we open the floor, please, for any question? Any question? Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Anyone who has a question may press star and one. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. Anyone who has a question may enter star and one. Our first question is from the line of Divesh Shah from the an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Yes, sir. Sir, thanks for the opportunity. My question is regarding our new promising segment, quartz. I think the day before yesterday, you came out with an announcement about the USA has reduced the duty on quartz for Indian quartz and increased the duty for Chinese quartz. So can you please elaborate total, what is the total USA size for quartz, Chinese market in USA that can be replaced by Indian market? And how much we are exporting to USA or total our quartz export? And what are our planning for next 2 years for quartz exports, especially?
Thank you very much for asking a very, very relevant question of the time, basically. This political change in the world powers, like, you know, what has shifted some commercial powers from one to another places also. And in line with that, US has already imposed a very heavy anti-dumping duty on various Chinese products, which includes tiles and quartz also. China have already been always been a favorable business partner with US, but in last 3 or 4 months, if you see, the things have changed. This time they have imposed 750% duty on Chinese product, which is specifically I'm talking about quartz. Whereas tiles, they have imposed around 350% duty, and quartz is around 330% duty they have imposed. Whereas on Indian product, the duty is only 8% and 3% respectively, 8% and 3% respectively. So this would definitely open doors for Indian supplier and similarly suppliers from some other countries. Quartz is by and large is a new segment. There are very few production lines in the world. Still it was dominated by China. China used to be 51% partner of quartz business with US. The total size of the US business in Indian currency, if we talk about it, is approximately 11,000 crores, and out of which around 51% was controlled by China. So this is a substantially large number as of now, if you see, and it was followed by Spain. Now, when we talk about China and Spain, there is a big difference between these two countries. Spain cannot be compared with China because of the cost effectiveness. China has always been a supplier which is supplying reasonably good quality with cost-effective method or model. So India is following the similar model. We have a good quality. Our new lines, which is much more modified, much more advanced line, will provide much better quality, better thicknesses, better sizes, better shape of quartz, and suitable to the US market. So this year we are expecting substantial good growth in tile business. We are also investing in a new line which is going to come into our 100% subsidiary in Amazon Ceramics. And first time we are going to use robotic technology for manufacturing quartz. This technology also gives us a better quality, better sizes and better thicknesses, and even better printing also. Printing in terms of better mixing. So all together, this will give us a better product to offer to US at par with China, which China was controlling. So this is going to be one important segment for us in this year 2020-21, as well as in 2021-22.
But sir, in the presentation, you have shown a segmental revenue for quartz is 180 crore
for financial year. We are existing in the same market, and we have already done this business last year also. 180 crore is the right figure you have mentioned. That's the correct figure.
Out of which, how much was the export?
100 crore was export last year.
So 80 crore was domestic and 100 crore was export. So what are you expecting next 2 years?
Next year, I mean, I think 21-22, we are talking about, we should touch around 250 crore rupees of exports only.
250 crore of export.
Correct. 21-22.
And local and domestic? about roughly?
Maintain the same figure. Domestic would not change much because domestic market is stagnated. It is not growing, and I think maybe there will be in total market maybe a small degrowth because it's a premium market, but we will recover it in international market.
And sir, any capex for quartz for next 2 years? Or we have a capacity?
That's why our chairman, because he was involved personally in implementing this project, so he would tell you about the technology as well as the investment also in quartz. Kamlesh bhai,
normal hamare paas mein EGL ke paas mein 3 line already quartz ki hai, aur pehle hamare paas mein Camrola mein humne investment kiya tha 51% joint partner the. Ab तो अभी हमने 100% हमारा खुद का प्लांट है. अमेजोन सिरामिक का भी हमने नया प्लांट किया है, तो जिसमें रोबोट हम लगा रहे हैं, और वहाँ करारा और कालाकटा जो प्रोडक्ट है, जो एक प्रीमियम सेगमेंट की प्रोडक्ट है, वो वहीं बनेगा और उससे रेवेन्यू 120 करोड़ का जनरेट होगा, और उसके अंदर टोटल कैपेक्स हमारा 25 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट रहेगा, और 120 करोड़ में जो दीपावली के टाइम में प्रोडक्शन हमारा स्टार्ट हो जाएगा, तो लास्ट जो क्वार्टर है उससे हमारा 30 करोड़ की रेवेन्यू वहीं से जनरेट होगा, और आने वाले समय में हम एक और प्लांट उसमें कैपेक्स कर सकते हैं जिसमें कम इन्वेस्टमेंट में, क्योंकि ऑलरेडी लैंड शेड और जगह वो सब हमारे पास में ऑलरेडी है, तो हम कम इन्वेस्टमेंट में मैक्सिमम हम कवर करें, ऐसी पोजीशन हमारा अमेजोन सिरामिक में है.
और कमलेश भाई, कैमरोला में वी हैव गॉट 51% नो राइट?
नहीं, हम उसमें से विड्रॉल हुए हैं, उसके बाद में ही अमेजोन प्लांट में नया इन्वेस्टमेंट कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि हमने 7 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट अमेजोन कैमरोला में किया था, तो वहां से हमने 11 करोड़ हमको बायबैक मिला, और हमने वहां से और वही इन्वेस्टमेंट हमने अमेजोन में टेक्नोलॉजी के साथ में किया, और वहाँ 100% अपनी सब्सिडरी कंपनी है.
और दूसरा कमलेश भाई, मेरे पास जो मार्केट का जो रूमर्स मतलब न्यूज है वो के सिंस यूएसए ने चाइना को ड्यूटी बढ़ा दिया है, तो चाइनीज जो चाइनीज मैन्युफैक्चरर है वो आर लुकिंग एट द इंडियन पार्टनर्स, इंडियन पार्टनर के साथ वो ज्वाइन करके ऑन इंडियन सॉइल विद द चाइनीज अप्लायंसेस मशीनरी दे वांट टू एक्सपोर्ट टू यूएसए बिकॉज दे कैन नॉट मिस द यूएस मार्केट. तो इसके बारे में आपका क्या ख्याल है कि चाइनीज
चाइनीज लोग ऑलरेडी इंडिया में पार्टनर ढूंढ रहे हैं, और हमारे पास में भी एक इंक्वायरी है, लेकिन आज अभी देखिए 10-15 दिन से चाइना की जो पोजीशन है इंडिया का पोजीशन के साथ में, उसमें कोई भी आदमी ऐसा इंसिस्ट नहीं करेगा, क्योंकि हमारे पास में इतनी अपॉर्चुनिटी है. हमने अभी रिसेंट ऑल ओवर यूएस के अंदर 4-5 डेस्टिनेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर डिसाइड किए हैं, उसमें एक जगह पे हमारा जून महीने में टाइल्स कॉर्नर के नाम से एक्सक्लूसिव हमारा शोरूम वहाँ ओपन हो गया है. हम डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर तौर पे यूएस के अंदर 5 ऐसे एक्सक्लूसिव शोरूम बनाने वाले हैं, उसमें फर्स्ट हमारा एक शोरूम इनोग्रेट हो गया है.
और कमलेश भाई, क्वार्ट्स मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में कॉस्ट वाइज हाउ कॉम्पिटेटिव वी आर विद चाइना? चाइना के साथ कंपेरिजन में अपना कॉम्पिटिशन कैसा है कॉस्ट वाइज?
चाइना की कंपैरिजन में मतलब हम ये दफा जो हमारा लॉकडाउन नहीं होता तो चाइना में हम एग्जीबिशन शामेन एग्जीबिशन है उसमें हम ये दफा पार्टिसिपेट करने वाले थे, और अगले साल भी हमारा शामेन एग्जीबिशन में और गोंगजो में हमारे एग्जीबिशन में क्वार्ट्ज में पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे, क्योंकि हमारी जो प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट है, जो बेटर क्वालिटी क्वार्ट्ज है, आज की तारीख में भी वियतनाम यहाँ से जाता है, ताइवान यहाँ से जाता है जो रॉ मटेरियल है, इवन यूएस भी यहाँ से जाता है, तो वो जो मटेरियल है उस वो मटेरियल से हमारी बेटर क्वालिटी है, और लेबर कॉस्ट हमारा इंडिया का कम है, तो हम डेफिनेट वर्ल्ड वाइड में कॉम्पीट करेंगे.
एंड ऑल्सो वेन वी टॉक अबाउट इंटरनेशनल मार्केट, देर इज ए प्रीमियम ऑफ इंडियन प्रोडक्ट ओवर चाइनीज प्रोडक्ट. चाइनीज प्रोडक्ट जब भी किसी भी काउंटर पे ऑफर किया जाता है, इट इज ऑलवेज ट्रीटेड एज ए डिस्काउंटेड प्रोडक्ट, इट इज नॉट ट्रीटेड एज ए रेस्पेक्टेड प्रोडक्ट, एनी प्रोडक्ट यू टॉक अबाउट इट. सो वेन वी से दैट इज मेड इन इंडिया, इट ऑलवेज हैज ए लिटिल प्रीमियम ओवर चाइना. So even if we are at par with cost also, we are competitive in terms of quality also, and there is a small extra premium also we get in the market being an Indian product.
Okay, sir. Thank you. I will come in the queue for next question. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Any participant who has a question may enter star and one on their touchtone telephone. Ladies and gentlemen, if you wish to ask a question, you may enter star and one. We have a question from the line of Sunil Shah from Total Star Capital. Please go ahead.
Sir, I have one question. You stated that this year our export can grow from 100 crores to 250 crores. Sir, largely this incremental 150 crores we expect to come from the US market?
I think there is a little gap between the information. What I have mentioned very categorically that year 2021-22, we would be doing it. We would be doing it. And this year it was, you know, we have given the figures which like 158 crore we have done it. And we try to achieve, we'll try to achieve something around 275 to 280 crore for the total gross exports I am talking about. And per se, we are talking about specifically about the quads. Quads will give us something around 250 crore in the year 21-22.
Yeah, sir, I'm talking about quads itself. That this year, our exports of quads was...
No, this year
meaning FY20. FY20, we've done 100 crores of exports, right? Of quads?
Yes, true.
So, by FY22, we'll do about 250 crores?
Yes, you're right.
So that incremental 150 crores we expect to come from the US market?
Right. Mostly. 90% US.
Okay. And sir, how important is technology in this field? Because if, you know, the price advantage which has come to India versus China, so can other players easily set up this plant or technology is very important? Could you make us understand that what is the technology barrier in this industry?
It's not just a technology, even in the process is a big barrier, you know. Some manufacturing companies which has come in, you know, late 90s and early 20s, if you go 2000, you see they failed only because they could not set the process. It's not just buying a machine, you know. It's not just like, you know, buying a luxury car and you don't know the driving. So you need to know the proper driving also to have a luxury car. So something like this, you technology is available. I am not saying technology machines anybody can buy. But the setting up the process, making up a mix, mix is important. You know, it's very, very important how to make a mix because people takes like months together, years together to settle down with the right product, right thickness, right design and right shine. So we are already like ahead in this. We already crossed this all barriers. Our product is very well acceptable in the international market. We already have been selling it. We already have been getting repeated orders. So our status is very different than other. So maybe if somebody wants to enter into the line, they will face a lot of barriers, not just buying a technology and implementing a project. Other issues are also will be going to be there.
Right. Okay. So one important point is, is there any small unorganized player from Morbi area or from anywhere else in the country who is also doing this, you know, quartz business, meaning how is the market segmented? Could you just give me some more understanding on that?
At present, the Morbi unorganized player may be 3-4 log hain overall, Gujarat mein aur Rajasthan mein. लेकिन जो टेक्नोलॉजी के साथ में जो प्लांट है एक ऑर्गेनाइज प्रोडक्ट के साथ में एक्सपोर्ट ओरिएंटेड के हिसाब से गुजरात में ओनली एशियन है और 2011 में हमने फर्स्ट लाइन डाला था उसके बाद में 2014-15 में एक लाइन डाला 2018 में एक लाइन डाला और अभी अमेजोन में हम जो प्लांट डाल रहे हैं वो एकदम लेटेस्ट और मॉडर्न प्लांट है जहाँ करारा और कालाकटा जो प्रोडक्ट है फर्स्ट टाइम भी इंट्रोडक्शन इन इंडिया जो रोबोटिक प्लांट है तो हमने टेक्नोलॉजी के साथ में एक ऑर्गेनाइज ब्रांड के साथ में यूएस में एजीएल की ब्रांड पॉपुलर हो ऐसा हमने ध्यान में रख के ये प्रोडक्ट और प्लांट हम लॉन्च कर रहे हैं।
सर वन मोर पॉइंट, आपने स्टार्टिंग में ये बताया था कि 11,000 करोड़ इज द अपॉर्चुनिटी साइज ऑफ क्वार्ट्ज बिजनेस इन अमेरिका एंड 51% वॉज बींग डन बाई चाइना.
Yes.
You also mentioned that Spain is another country which was exporting. Spain ka kitna share tha? How much was the share that?
I will first correct you. It is 11,000 crore. Okay.
Yes.
For China. Only cost is 11,000 crore.
Yeah. And okay. Spain is doing around 2,000 to 2,200 crore now with the increased number.
Okay. So,
1500 crore before, but now they have already started increasing their share in the market. Vietnam and Spain is very aggressively doing and they are increasing. We have observed the numbers are going up Spain has already reached up to around 2,200 crore. I think they will cross 3,000 crore in the coming year.
Okay. Sir, so 11,000, we say, how much was India doing earlier?
Only 600 crore.
It's 6%. Only 6% approximately we were having. And we intend to grow this year at least by another 5%. I mean, we should have something around 10% market share totally in US this year.
Okay. And sir, we also expect that the margins would also improve because the pricing flexibility will also be there now that, you know, the duty is down from 85% to something around 3%. So that will help us to have some better pricing also, and because of which margin will also be better off.
Certainly, you are absolutely correct. It will ease out the pressure on pricing and the margins would be better because pressure on pricing comes only with China. See, most of the other manufacturers are comparatively more decent manufacturers and not, you know, very, very aggressive suppliers in the market. Whenever there is a competition with Chinese product, then a lot of pressure is there on pricing, especially when we talk about Israel as a manufacturer of cords, Spain as a manufacturer of cords, a leading manufacturer. They are not the one, they don't play these dirty games mostly.
Okay. Fine. Thanks, sir. Thanks so much. All the best in the opportunity which is there. We look forward to great numbers from all of you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Any participant who has a question may enter star and one. Our next question is from the line of Shrenik Jain from JM Financial. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. Sir, can you throw some light at the capacity utilization for tiles industry currently, that is in Morbi, and on the Gujarat gas prices at Morbi, if they have fallen recently in the last 1-2 months?
Total Morbi and Gujarat 900 manufacturing plant is there. Usme se 300 plant at present chal rahe hain, aur jahan labor problem nahi hai, itne plant abhi chal rahe hain. 600 plant अभी लॉकडाउन में पोजीशन में है और जो एग्जिस्टिंग प्लांट है वो इतने लोग उनकी कैपेसिटी 80% से पूरा चला रहा है.
एंड गैस प्राइस
पहले की कंपैरिजन में अभी 2.5 रुपया पर क्यूबिक डाउन हुआ है और फर्दर भी डाउन होने की पूरी गुंजाइश है.
It is corrected with the global prices. So global prices is under pressure. So I think this would keep going on. I mean, another couple of months also, it would remain the same situation.
Okay. And so labor cost, can you throw some light? At the labor, I have heard that labor cost has gone up by 5 to 10% in Morbi area. Is it true?
You are saying gone up or gone down?
Up.
No,
not exactly. It's not there. The availability of labor is a question. The price is not a question today. In fact, you know, they are desperate to work. All the people, those who are available, they are desperate to work. But number of availability is less. And that is the first reason why this another 60% companies have not yet started.
So, sir, if you have any view of by when can they return or when can production normalize?
See, people are, you know, it is happening. It is in the process. But there is a psychological fear, you know, it's not just like a physical factor. It is more is a psychological factor also. And government is providing them a lot of packages and goodies. So it's difficult to say that by when they will be back. Monsoon is already on, so a lot of labor would be involved now in kharif ka fasal mein. So they would be doing their job there in seeding and all. So it might take some time to normalize the situation and come out of this fear of COVID right now. But as I mentioned in the beginning, and I am pleased to repeat it again, that you know, our all the 10 factories are working. We are manufacturing with full capacity as of now. Also, we have full order, like, you know, and even pending orders of exports also, more than 100 containers as of now is lined up for this month.
Okay. So the domestic new orders are coming from, can you tell us it is coming from which segment, like, is it institutional, retail, or like what is driving the demand currently and what will demand drive the tile demand over the next 1 year?
We already जो metro है, जो Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore और Chennai already lockdown है, तो अभी हमारे जो position है वो B और C town से ही पूरी demand अभी at present generate हो रही है. पूरा जून महीना हमारे जो demand रहा वो जून वो पूरा हो रहा है. हमको उम्मीद है कि जैसे जैसे एक महीने के बाद में जो normal position होगा तो अभी B और C town की demand और ज्यादा रहेगी. और institution जो sell है उसमें government में आज जस्ट हमें अभी सूरत रिसेंट कोविंद हॉस्पिटल बन रही है, तो वहाँ पूरा हमारा डबल चार्ज की प्रोडक्ट वहाँ पूरा करीबन 30,000 स्क्वायर मीटर सिंगल डे हमने ऑर्डर उठाया और डिस्पेच किया. तो गवर्नमेंट में पूरा फुल फ्लेक्स चल रहा है अभी.
कैसे लाइक टू मेंशन दैट डिमांड्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम बी एंड सी कैटेगरीज ऑफ सिटी, जहां पर लेबर का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, रिवर्स माइग्रेशन नहीं है, वहां पर कंस्ट्रक्शन एक्टिविटीज आर इन फुल फ्लेज्ड. जैसे ही लॉकडाउन खुला, जो पेंडिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स थे सब कंप्लीट होने लगे एंड डिमांड्स आर बीइंग जनरेटेड. सो देयर इज अ बिग डिमांड फ्रॉम इंस्टीट्यूशनल एंड गवर्नमेंट प्रोजेक्ट्स. रिटेल भी वहां पर शुरू हो गया है. वी आर ओनली लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू कि ये बिग सिटीज जैसी खुलेंगी वहां पर भी ये चालू हो जाएंगे. दे आर रेयरिंग टू गो. अनफॉर्चुनेटली वहां की गवर्नमेंट अभी उनको पूरी परमिशन नहीं दे पा रही है. तो वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग कि अनदर वन मंथ, एज यू अंडरस्टूड दैट टुडे गवर्नमेंट हैज अनाउंस दैट विद इन वन मंथ दे आर गोइंग टू लॉन्च द वैक्सीन एंड ऑल. तो वी एक्सपेक्ट कि एक महीने के बाद चीजें पूरी नॉर्मलाइज हो जाएंगी ऑल ओवर इंडिया. बट अभी बी और सी कैटेगरी की सिटीज आर गिविंग अस अ बिग बूस्ट. We are actually present in a very good number and वो हमारी sales team वहाँ पर मौजूद है, जो institutional और retail sales हमारी देख रही है. तो they are good position.
So and the cost reduction measures that we are doing and the savings in gas cost should overall help us in maintaining the margin. Is it fair understanding?
There are two ways of cost reduction. One is we are getting benefits. One is like, you know, organic and unorganic, or natural and unnatural. Natural cost factor, what we have got it this year is a reduction in gas price. Okay, that is one which is a national factor has given it. Second, as I mentioned to you, that chairman has already implemented one new program, which is Atmanirbhar program, as well as which is going to contribute into reduction in the cost of our cost of sales. So as if you see our numbers, our cost of sales is around 12% of the total sales. We have a target to reduce it to something around 10 to 9% this year by digitalization process and digitalizing the whole process by reduction of marketing expenses, sales promotion expenses, which includes the distribution of samples, physical visit to the counters. So all these things, you know, travel and advertisement expenses. So this will reduce, I think, by around 2 to 3% we would be able to reduce by the year end total cost in sales and marketing also.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
We'll take a next question from the line of Chirag Loraya from ValueQuest. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. Sir, this duty changes which you have mentioned, cost and time, which the anti-dumping duty has increased for Chinese products. This how to implement hua hai?
From which repeat the question, please. I could not get your question.
Is it audible now?
Yes.
Yeah, now it is audible, Mr. Chair. Yeah.
Yeah. So this Chinese anti-dumping duty on cost and time, ये इफेक्टिव डेट कब से है सर? व्हेन दिस गॉट इंप्लीमेंटेड दिस ड्यूटी?
जस्ट 18 तारीख को ड्यूटी हुआ पोर्ट पे, वो पहली तारीख हुआ. तो जस्ट आप समझिए कि 15 दिन की प्रोसेस में ये सब कुछ हुआ है.
ओके, सो नाउ ओके ओके ओके. एंड हाउ इंडियन एक्सपोर्ट्स दिस सऊदी अरेबिया में जो एंटी डंपिंग ड्यूटी लगा है, हाउ यू सी दैट डेवलपमेंट फॉर इंडियन टाइल्स एक्सपोर्ट?
No, Saudi Arabia is a very structured anti-dumping duty. In fact, they have already made a list of Indian manufacturers under different categories. We are already one of the registered vendor and our subsidiaries are also one of the registered vendor. So we are very comfortable with Saudi Arabia anti-dumping duty. In fact, we would get a bigger number this year with this new structure.
Okay, okay. So, apna sir, overall tiles export kitna tha this year, FY20?
This FI 20 you are talking about, or 21 2021 you want to know?
FY20, we have done around 60 crores in tiles export, which we are thinking that with the US market opening up to us when China is going out. So we are expecting this market to grow exponentially, and we are looking at a double-digit growth in this market also.
So, sir, this 60 crore export in this year, how big can it be in next 1 or 2 years for us, for tiles?
Tile segment will definitely will grow because of not only one reason is that China. The second reason is accessibility of our product, to new markets. So as of now, we are doing already exports to around 55 to 57 countries. And we intend to do this year in 2020-21 something around 75 countries. That is one number of countries. Second, we are going to penetrate our products into the couple of large markets like USA and Europe and Australia. So that will increase the number. Third, being a registered vendor in Saudi Arabia, we would definitely fetch a better number and better sales figure in this year from Saudi Arabia and Middle East also. Total last year we have done something around 158 crore exports, and we intend to touch this year around 275 crore exports, which includes the cords also.
Got it, sir. And sir, what is the margin in cords business? What is the EBITDA margin in cords business for us?
Margins is like, it is a widespread margin. So, at the end, it is something plus 20%, I can say, in general, because,
Okay.
So, product to product, it varies between 18 to 25%, and overall, it remains at 20-21%.
Got it. And just lastly, so your commentary is being pretty strong compared to opening up of plant. When I look at your peers, barring say Murbi, all these other listed entity or say organized players, nobody has been able to open plant more than one or two. But we have opened all the plants. So this bullishness is coming from export opportunity, or it is domestic also you are seeing lot of traction currently?
Both. We have a huge number of pending exports right now. Okay, so we are doing that also, as well as our, the advantage is we were not dominated in dominating player in A-class cities. We are like our peers. Our peers are not the Morbi, Our peer is basically organized sector companies like Somani, Kajaria, Johnson. They are the one. Okay, they have their major market share is from the metro cities. We are mostly we have a major market share in B and C class cities, where our vendors have, our dealers have already started functioning. And there are pending projects like, small houses, small colonies, some government projects, some new hospitals, some new kind of schools and all these things. So there we are supplying material, and we have already started servicing them.
Right. And sir, lastly, gas price benefit, how it will flow in the numbers this year? So do you think corresponding price decrease will also happen with gas price going down, or you will be able to retain large part of gas price decline benefit?
It can happen when you see all the factories are operating. Right now, only 33% or 35% factories are operating. So there would not be in any case any pressure on the price right now. Okay, there is a disbalance in demand and supply. Right now the situation is very different than what used to be, say, in 2019 beginning.
Right. So you don't expect any pricing pressure, at least in near term?
Yeah, absolutely. In nearby, I don't see anything like that.
Got it, sir. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Our next question is from the line of Asim Bharte from IDFC Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Good evening, everyone. Thanks for the opportunity.
Good evening.
The first question, so you mentioned that in B and C category cities where you're seeing growth. So actually, I wanted to know, is this only pent-up demand, or do you see signs of new work also on the ground? Any new project launches, small-scale residential construction or affordable housing there?
You are very rightly, you have mentioned, one is a pending demand. The last two quarters, there is a huge pending demand is there. Second is, you know, you would see a big change, the migration, reverse migration from metros to B, C and D class cities. Government would also open up a lot of this budget housing schemes, and which is already there also. Income tax also has a separate provision for this kind of a segment. So I think in total, there would be a good demand and a good rise in numbers from these cities.
So new demand should start trickling in maybe in some time in the future, but not right now. Right now, it is mostly pent-up demand, right?
It's not like that. It's like together. It is mixed. It is mixed both the situation right now. It is new demand also have started coming in from these cities. Now, I'm not talking about metros at all. And I think
Okay, okay, sure. Sir, second question, could you just explain more about the ATD in GCC countries? You mentioned that it is a very structured and that you are very comfortable there. So does this mean that even with anti-dumping duty, this market will still be competitive for you? Because my understanding was that GCC ATD makes India uncompetitive in this in these countries.
See, in case of GCC countries, basically, specifically when talk about Saudi Arabia, they have structurized completely on basis of some information provided by Indian government and as well as Indian suppliers. So they have rated them on the basis of background of the manufacturers and background capacities and everything. And accordingly, they have levied the percentage of anti-dumping duty. You know, if there is a trader, then the number is very high. If there is a genuine manufacturer, number is as a amount is very low. So we are already one of the vendor into it. Our associates also in the same category, they are also listed vendor, and our outsourcing partners also part of that list. So in total, we are very comfortable in the present situation that we can compete with others and we can continue with our business right now. You know, it's not like anti-dumping duty what we see in India or we see in some other part of the world, which is like across the board as flat percentage. Okay, there it is very reckless sometimes because people, they manage left and right and they try to enter into the market. But this is on point and to the vendor. So it's more easy to operate there. And it is more easy to operate with your own brand. So if, see, when there is a across the board flat anti-dumping duty, a lot of people have to forego their brand because they want to enter through some or other sources. Okay, here, if it is a structured duty, you can still play with your own brand because you know that my duty is this much and my landed cost is this much. So your dealer is comfortable in that price.
But I think as far as what I understand, barring one or two companies, most companies are in the 46% and beyond bracket of anti-dumping duty. So I presume even you guys are at the 46% level. So even at 46%, the market still makes sense for you guys. Is that what you're saying?
So our associates are on a lower bracket also. Our associates and our outsourcing partners are also in lower bracket also.
Okay.
You are rightly have studied. We are into 46% level, but you know our around 60% business is still all from the outsourcing partners, and they all are based in Morbi. So that is possible for us to get into it.
But how many companies have been selected for a lower duty? Is there a number out there?
Total number is very large number. It's almost like, you know, 200 companies have been registered in this, and the process are maybe still on. I don't know about it exactly, but process may be on. So it's a large number of companies already registered.
No. I understand. I was just asking, like, how many companies, including the associate partners, would be in the lower anti-dumping duty bracket?
No, we have not categorized it so far, and we have not done that kind of analysis on the number of duties and number of companies. So it is difficult to reply at this point.
What we understand, I'd like to add one point. What we understand is that Morbi associations and government of India has also taken up the duty issues with GCC countries. And most probably within a period of, say, 6 months or so, we'll see a revision. So we understand that revisions may come in shorter time.
Okay. So just one final question. Assuming most of Morbi is not competitive in the GCC countries, where would all these exports go? Would it be, would US be a easy market to crack, or would there be other markets where Morbi players will have to focus more on?
No, Morbi is a very large player in African market. They have a huge market size in Africa and East Europe. So they are doing it a substantial good business in Eastern Europe, then some part of Russia also, Africa also, and little bit in USA.
Okay. Sure. Thanks a lot for answering all my questions. Thank you
so much. Pleasure.
Thank you. Our next question is from the line of Sunil Shah from Total Star. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Kamlesh, I have one question for you. So there is one more company which I understand is in for the quartz business is Pokarna. Sir, how does that company compare with us? Yani, is it our competitor? Or what are the good things about Pokarna which we can learn here? And which are the things where we have an advantage over Pokarna? So I'm just trying to understand the competitive landscape between us and Pokarna. Could you just please make me understand, Kamlesh Bhai?
Pokarna is a Britain technology, and Pokarna is a 100% export-oriented unit. Their single piece is not selling in a domestic market. And Asian is a domestic company in India. And we have a three line, previous we have a three line. तो हमने पूरी लाइन तीनों तीन लाइन आज तक हम डोमेस्टिक मार्केट ही करते थे, लेकिन जो एंटी डंपिंग ड्यूटी जो यूएस का जो बेनिफिट हुआ कि हमारा 3.19% जो ड्यूटी लगी और चाइना का 330% ड्यूटी लगा, तो हमारे लिए बड़ी अपॉर्चुनिटी है। पोकरना 100% एक्सपोर्ट करता था यूएस में, अभी हमारा जो नया लाइन कर रहे हैं वो भी हम 100% एक्सपोर्ट के लिए लगा रहे हैं। और पोकरना इज अ ब्रिटेन टेक्नोलॉजी, उसकी कॉस्ट भी ज्यादा है प्लांट मशीनरी की, और जो सेलिंग प्राइस है वो भी एट प्रेजेंट ज्यादा है। उससे हमारा जो डोमेस्टिक जो प्राइस है और इंटरनेशनल प्राइस है वो भी एट प्रेजेंट करीबन 15-20% का प्राइस सेलिंग प्राइस में भी डिफरेंस है।
सी पोकरना इज अ एस्टेब्लिश्ड प्लेयर एंड इट इज गोइंग टू बी देयर इन यूएस मार्केट, बट द साइज ऑफ द मार्केट विच इज नाउ अवेलेबल इज अ मच मच लार्जर देन द कैपेसिटी व्हाट पोकरना इज हैविंग। Pokarna total size is hardly 2% or 2.5% of the total US market. And leftover size today, because China is out, is like almost 50%. So grabbing a small piece of cake is not a big issue right now in US market.
Okay. Sir, I believe Pokarna is having some 30% margin in their, quartz exports. Sir, so can we aspire to reach those levels of margin in our quartz exports?
Actually, Kamlesh Bhai has very rightly said, no, this is, he said very clearly that, they are already established and they are making 30% profit. We are comparatively a new and we are a beginner in this line. So we are pegging at 20 plus, but definitely with the new sizes, new product range in the by the end of this financial year, you would see we would also reach something around 25%+.
Fine, sir. All the best. Thanks for the clarification. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
We have our next question from the line of Divyesh Shah, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Welcome, Divyesh.
Hello. Thank you. My next question is for Kamlesh Bhai. Kamlesh Bhai, ये industries काफी साल से organized और unorganized player का competition में ज्यादातर Morbi के side से unorganized player से competition हो रहा था। तो मेरे को अभी आपका व्हाट इज योर व्यू अबाउट मोरबी, बिकॉज अभी जहां तक मेरे पास लेटेस्ट रिपोर्ट है कि मोरबी में जो 900 यूनिट है उसमें से अबाउट 100 यूनिट इज परमानेंटली क्लोज, बिकॉज यहाँ ऐसा रूमर है बाजार में कि सूरत के जो डायमंड ट्रेडर्स थे दे वेर फाइनेंसिंग टू द मोरबी प्लेयर, और अभी वो डायमंड मार्केट के अंदर काफी परेशानी है, फाइनेंशियल ट्रबल्स में है, तो दे ऑल विड्रॉन फ्रॉम द मोरबी प्लेयर्स, तो फाइनेंशियल ताकत मोरबी प्लेयर्स की कम हो गई है, और 90 मेरे हिसाब से 90-100 ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस मोरबी में कंप्लीटली क्लोज डाउन हो गए हैं। तो कमलेश भाई आपका व्हाट इज योर व्यू एंड हाउ डू यू सी मोरबी कमिंग अप इन नेक्स्ट टू इयर्स?
As far as this financial issue is concerned, I think let me just take this liberty to speak on behalf of Kamlesh bhai. We cannot comment about what is happening between them and their promoters. So, frankly speaking, we have no idea about it. We only know because of the scarcity of labor, they have not yet started again. So, that is what exactly we know. Rest of the things, frankly speaking, even Kamlesh bhai would not be able to speak and say something on this thing. This is definitely their internal matter. Maybe what your information have may be correct, may not be correct. So I don't know.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was the last question. I now hand the floor back to the management for closing comments. Over to you, sir.
I heartily extend my warm thanks to everybody who has spent their valuable time to join us and give us an opportunity to express our views and express our commitment towards the growth of the company. On behalf of our chairman, Mr. Kamlesh Patel, I can assure and I can promise this year going to be a better than previous year. We would certainly going to do better than the earlier numbers and perform better. And I'm sure we will see with much better results in coming time. Thank you for joining us. Thank you very much.